and it's Holly back with another Tutorial Tuesday. I'm so excited to show you guys a design I've been using for over a year now, maybe 2 years. And I just realized I don't think I've ever done a video on it for everybody to see. It's kind of been like this little thing I've been keeping to myself. So it's a really fast line work owl, and I've loved using this one, and so I'm excited to share it with you guys tonight. So you might see a version of him peeking over, looking at us today, so you can look at him for inspiration. All right, so this balloon only uses 2 260s, and I've inflated them left about 3 or 4 inch tail. And you're gonna need a heart, a white heart, or whatever color one you use for the eyes. I've inflated the heart and then let the air out until it looks more like a ball than a heart, okay? Just set that aside for a second till you're ready for it. I'm playing with pumpkin spice again tonight because it's such a fun color. And owls are kind of reddish, some owls are. And so it's really a great color for like hawks and owls and other predatory birds that are like red-tailed hawks, you know, they kind of have that, you all know what I'm talking about. So we're gonna start. I'm using the pumpkin spice for the body and yellow for the beak and feet. So you start off with 2 loops, and these are pretty big loops. You know, I got my hand wide open here. I'm gonna do 2 of the same size loops. There, like that, okay? And then I'm gonna do a pinch twist, 1 pinch twist in the back. All right, so we've got this so far. And our yellow is just gonna hang out here for a second. We grab your heart, and you want to check out your heart. You can see the darker, let's see here, I'll show you real quick. So on your heart, where the 2 lobes are supposed to be, you'll see the latex is thicker in those areas. And you wanna come in between those 2 spots and grip your balloon, and we're gonna twist it in half, okay? So I'm gonna take 2 hands, thumbs on the nozzle, and then fingers kind of walking around, splitting that heart in half till you get 2 lobes like this. Okay, and your lobes will be bigger on one side. That's the side that would have been the top of the heart. You want to make sure to keep an eye on where those at. So mine are both facing up right now. If I had blown this balloon up, this would have been the top of the heart and this would have been the bottom. So just kind of keep your eye on where those parts are. And we're gonna just twist this into here. You can use your pumpkin spice balloon to wrap it around and just get them interlocked in here, okay? Now, the part of these 2 things here, they kind of look like eggs. The part that would have been the top of the heart, okay, that is what we're gonna take the loop over. I'm just gonna wedge it, right, so it's sitting on top. Do the same thing on the other side, wedge it on down there. Okay, and then your yellow balloon is gonna come out the front like this. All right. Okay, now we're gonna do a loop with the yellow. So it's gonna kinda come down underneath the eyes and then meet back up in the pinch twist in the back here. I'm just gonna twist it in. I'm gonna switch it so my yellow's coming out the back and I've got my pumpkin spice going down here, okay? And don't worry about if the eyes get kind of messed up while we're working. We'll fix it all before we're done. Now for the body, I'm just gonna do a 3-bubble bird body. So come down about 3 to 4 inches, go back up, twist that in, and then the rest of your balloon, you're gonna come back down, and you can either tuck the tail through here and pull it through, or you could do the 3-bubble roll through, whatever you're comfortable with. So he just ends up with 3 bubbles for his body. And then for the feet, we're gonna use the rest of this. So you can cut it off, and if you're able to, just kind of save the rest of this. I'm gonna tie it off, and we're gonna make his feet. So I'm gonna do 2 to 3 inch bubbles 1, 2, twist them together by grabbing that knot and really twisting it around and through the feet. And same thing for the other side. And then we can get rid of the rest. I'm not even gonna tie it. I'm just going to push it through the feet a couple times. And then it's gonna come from behind the body, over that tail and up forward towards the front, okay? And now to really get this so that he's got that like mean mug and owl look, you're gonna bring his beak. You're gonna wedge this loop down in between his two front body bubbles, okay? And then just play with the angle of his eyebrows so that he has that kind of angry looking owl face. Give him some character. Here we go. Hey, hey. And now for the eyes. Where'd my marker go? Here we go. So owls have really big eyes, right? So don't draw tiny little dots here for the eyes. You want to go nice and big circles. Whoops. Totally messed that one up. But that's all right, because we're going to fill it in. So I did a little circle in between there, and I'm going to fill in the outside of that with my black marker until it's all filled in. All right, woo-hoo. And do the same thing for the other side. All right, so there is a really fast, pretty fast line work owl. So I know there's better owls out there, but they're not quick, right? So this is a really good one for the upcoming fall season where you do a lot of festivals and it's a lot of line work usually. This is a nice one to have on your menus. And I do have the clip art available for this on my website, thetwistersister.com. So you can download the digital graphic that goes with this and put it on your menu because menus are perfect for line work. So go grab that and hopefully it helps you guys out. You can make it girly too. You can do some purple, some pink. So it doesn't have to be super realistic. But that's it. That is the owl for this week. I hope you guys like this one. Let me know what you think. And don't forget, I'm going to be teaching at Capital Kidvention this year. I'll be there in DC January 25th through the 27th. I hope to see you guys there with me. It's gonna be a blast. So come join me and I'll see you guys next week.